With your sports on demand for Sunday, February 17th, I'm Alex Klein. Marquette Mountain was the place to be this weekend. They had snow, not too much wind, pleasant temperatures, and it was the site of the Midwest Collegiate Ski Association regional qualifier. 14 collegiate ski and snowboard club teams from across the Midwest were at the mountain trying to punch their ticket to USCSA Nationals. The event you're seeing right here is the men's border cross final. Snowboarders have to race down the track going through the gates. The guy in front is Iowa State's Ryan Franzen, closely followed by Ohio State's Ben Barbie. Barbie overtook the lead there at the end to take first place, but both Franzen and Barbie qualified for the national event. And coming up next is the Alpine Giant Slalom. While it is an individual race, these skiers compete for the fastest time as a team, with only the top two men's and women's teams qualifying to go to nationals in Jackson, Wyoming. Two Marquette natives who now go to the University of Michigan took advantage of coming back to their home mountain and did well enough to take second for the men.
It's really special being out here. You know, you have your old parents and coaches. I haven't seen you ski in a couple of years, and we get to get back out here and get on snow and nice steep hill like Marquette Mountain. It's really fun.
Yeah, it's really exciting. We'll probably have to check the GPA financials, but I would expect to see the Wolverines in Wyoming.
St. Olaf took first place for both the men and women's Alpine, while UW-Madison took second for the women. In snowboarding, Michigan Tech won it for the men, and Ohio State took first for the women. The Upper Peninsula High School team bowling finals took place Saturday at River Rock Lanes in Ishpeming. Five bowlers combined to roll six Baker games, which means they take frames 1 and 6 or 2 and 7 and so on. Westwood's Alex Miller was the boys' individual champion 2 weeks ago. Here, he converts the 2-4-5 for a spare. After the Bakers games, the bowlers throw three team games, each one bowling 10 frames. The Westwood Patriots continued their fine season by sweeping the Baker series and the three team games. So here's a look at how the teams finished. Westwood captured that team title with 3,778 pins. Marquette was the runner-up and Ishpeming in third. And you can also see the UP Dream Team bowlers for this season. Marquette's Keenan Johnson had the highest average, just over 190 per game. He's followed by Iron Mountain's Zach Spera, Westwood's Stephen Kangas, Escanaba's Hunter Landcore, and Patriots' Dylan Junak. Westwood's Robert Papp is the honorable mention. And over to the girls now, and you can accomplish a lot, including some knitting while you're watching your grandchildren bowl. The girls' individual champion was crowned last weekend in Delta County. Iron Mountain's Lexi Jocko was the winner. And she doesn't worry about the TV cameras in the neighborhood too much. She finds the Brooklyn side for that strike. Escanaba, Iron Mountain, and Ishpeming were the top three teams during the regular season, but it was a much closer battle to see which girls' team emerged as this year's best. And here's a look at those final results. Escanaba did take the team title with 3,037 pins, followed by runner-up Iron Mountain, and finally Marquette in third. And the UP Girls Dream Team is as follows. Ishpeming's Megan Wilkins with an average just over 191. Escanaba's Dakota Cloutier, Marquette's Amanda McIntyre, the Eskimos' Lindsay Jewell, and the Redettes' Kaylee Reeder. Iron Mountain's Lexi Jocko is the honorable mention. Some basketball now. Bay College in Chicago this weekend facing Truman College, and we'll pick it up in the second half. Alfonso Fields goes to Christian Alexander inside. He had 13 points, and the Norse are up by 8. Next, off the Falcons miss, Bay College going the other way. And we're going to have some nice ball movement here. They get it back to Fields, and he gets the short jumper off glass. Norse up 51-39. Bay College keeps things going. Kobe Barnes gets it to Rapid River's Logan Hardwick. The Norse up by 20. Now Barnes can not only pass, but he can also score. Munising's Cade Contreras gets it to Barnes in the paint for the basket and the foul. Bay College wins on the road 79-65.